What is up, Linux lovers, and welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, and this is your weekly dose of Linux goodness. The last couple of weeks have been absolutely wild in the open source world. We're talking a brand new, built-from-scratch desktop environment that could change everything, a major kernel release with some serious performance boosts, and a new Raspberry Pi that's basically a full-fledged PC in a keyboard. So grab your coffee, settle in, and let's get right into the biggest Linux news from the past week. All right, first up, let's talk about the heart of our systems, the Linux kernel. On September 28th, Linus Torvalds officially dropped Linux 6.17, and this is a big one. This kernel is what will be powering upcoming distros like Ubuntu 25.10, and Fedora 43, so it gives us a great preview of what's to come. So what's new? Well, for all you gamers and graphics nerds out there, the big news is that Intel's Panther Lake XE3 graphics are now officially declared stable. This means we can expect much better support and performance for Intel's next-gen integrated graphics right out of the box. We're also seeing some great improvements for Intel's Project Battle Matrix, so things are looking really good on the Intel graphics front. But that's not all. Kernel 6.17 also brings mainline support for the Raspberry Pi RP1, the I/O controller on the Pi 5, and a new driver for the Intel IPU7. Plus, there are some significant scalability improvements to the ext4 file system, which should translate to better performance on systems with a lot of files. Feronix has been running some benchmarks, and they're reporting some really nice performance improvements across the board. So yeah, a very solid release. Now, let's talk distros. It's been a busy week for new releases and updates. The biggest news here is probably the public beta of MX Linux 25 Infinity, which is now based on the upcoming Debian 13 Trixie. This is a huge start for one of the most popular distros out there. We also saw the release of KOS Linux 2025.09, which is a beautiful, independent distro that's always on the cutting edge of KDE. This release ships with the latest KDE Plasma 6.4 and KDE Gear 25.08. And for all you security-minded folks, Kali Linux 2025.3 is out with 10 new hacking tools. So, have fun with that, responsibly, of course. And that's just scratching the surface. We also saw new releases from Blue Star Linux, Neptune OS, KDE Neon, and a bunch more. It's a great time to be a distro hopper. Okay, this next one is one I'm personally most excited about. System76 has finally released the beta of their brand new, built-from-scratch desktop environment called Cosmic. And with it, the beta of Pop! OS 24.04 LTS. Cosmic is a huge deal. It's written in Rust, and it's designed to be a modern, fast, and keyboard-driven desktop experience. The beta includes a bunch of new features, like a much improved file manager with a gallery mode, a new launcher with web search and a calculator, and some really advanced window tiling and stacking options. System76 is replacing all the GNOME apps with their own Cosmic apps, so this is a complete desktop experience. I've been playing around with the beta, and it's impressive. It's still a beta, of course, so there are some rough edges, but the potential here is massive. This could be a real game changer for the Linux desktop. On the KDE side of things, we're seeing a lot of bug fixing and polish going into the upcoming Plasma 6.5 release. And as I mentioned, KOS is already shipping with a beautiful implementation of Plasma 6.4. All right, let's talk hardware. The biggest news here is the launch of the Raspberry Pi 500 Plus. This thing is an absolute beast. It's an all-in-one PC built into a mechanical keyboard, and it's based on the Raspberry Pi 5. It's got a 2.4 GHz quad-core ARM CPU, 16 GB of RAM, that's right, 16 gigs, and a 256 GB M.2 SSD pre-installed. It's got dual 4K display output, Wi-Fi, and individually addressable RGB LEDs on the keyboard, because of course it does. This is a huge step up from the Pi 400, and it really blurs the line between a single board computer and a full-fledged desktop PC. For $200, this is an incredible value, and I can't wait to get my hands on one. And as we talked about earlier, the new Linux kernel is bringing much better support for Intel's upcoming hardware. So the future is looking bright for Linux on the latest and greatest machines. And finally, let's take a look at what's been happening in the wider Linux and open source community. The Linux Foundation made a huge announcement this week. The contribution of Newton, a new open source GPU accelerated physics engine for robotics simulation. This is a collaboration between Disney Research, Google DeepMind, and NVIDIA, which is a pretty serious lineup. Newton is designed to help researchers and developers build and train general-purpose robots in a realistic simulation environment. This is the kind of foundational open-source project that will drive innovation for years to come, and it's amazing to see it happening under the Linux Foundation umbrella. We also saw the kickoff of Hacktoberfest 2025, so if you've ever wanted to contribute to open-source, now is a great time to get involved. And the Open Source Security Foundation continues to do great work in making the entire open source ecosystem more secure. So there you have it, another packed week in the world of Linux, from a revolutionary new desktop environment to a major kernel release and some seriously cool new hardware. There's never a dull moment in our community. What are you most excited about? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell so you don't miss a single update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.